area native and political documentarian Michael Moore provides his own view of Flint auto downsizing in the 1980s. Hi, my name is Reginald Kaigler. I'm DimCad, and this is my review of Roger and Me. Roger and Me focuses on Michael Moore's attempt to interview GM CEO Roger Smith. Roger Smith was pretty much the face of GM for a fairly long time, and the film focuses on the effects of Roger Smith's decision to downsize the automotive industry in Flint, Michigan. And since Michael Moore is from the area, he decided to focus on how the people were being impacted in the area and try to really get many different sides to the whole incident. He talked about the city's, the government's response to the downsizing of the plants, and basically this is one of the most interesting, at times humorous and other times depressing view of what happened after Flint, Michigan went through this incredible deindustrialization. Basically, Michael Moore spends most of the film interviewing people, following a sheriff who is basically kicking ex-GM workers out of their houses. GM workers who are working at the new county jail that they built, well, at the time it was new. And trying to get an interview with the incredulous, well, at least that's how he portrays him, Mr. Smith. Now, the film is quite fascinating because it shows you how desperate some people became after the factory shut down. It also shows you how dependent the city of Flint was on GM and all of its manufacturing plants. The interesting thing about Flint is that not only was GM a big part of its economy, but a lot of other areas in the economy, a lot of other factories were dependent on GM. For example, many companies made parts for GM. They made spark plugs, they made this, they made that. A lot of items that end up on the GM vehicles came from other factories in Flint, Michigan. So it was like a massive domino effect. Right after the closure of the factories, there was clearly a major crime problem. There was a big exodus of people leaving the city. The city officials tried to revive the city by turning it into a tourist destination, which was quite fascinating. You learn about how we ended up with the pavilion, how we ended up with that big hotel downtown that doesn't really get used that much. You learn about Auto World, which was basically a big dome, a big indoor theme park, and it was expected to bring millions of people, or at least a million people, to the city of Flint as a tourist location. And there's a quote in the film that pretty much summed it up really well. You know, Flint is not a tourist location, and they spent millions of dollars on this project, and obviously it failed. It was one of the many attempts to sort of bring the city back or transform it. This film was made in 1989, so I really appreciate the timestamp that it provides for us. I also like how Michael Moore used his own family history to put a personal touch on the film. And who could ever forget the infamous Rabbit Lady? If you don't know who I'm talking about, she is worth watching in this film. I really appreciate Michael Moore's view. Even though a lot of his political movies I don't really agree with, he also did Fahrenheit 9/11. He did Bowling for Columbine. He has a liberal perspective on most of the social issues, but since I'm from Flint, Michigan, and since he pretty much focused on something that has really transformed so many people's lives in my area, I thought it was definitely worth checking out. I've seen this film a while ago, and watching it recently, I just couldn't help but recommend it to anyone who was interested in and getting to know Flint, Michigan, or a little bit about our past. So this perspective is valued, And I highly recommend Roger and Me for anybody who's interested in seeing the effects of the deindustrialization of America and really getting to know more about Flint, Michigan and cities like Flint, Michigan, because there's cities like Flint, Michigan all over the country. All right, guys. You can find me at dimcad.blogspot.com, or you can find me on YouTube under Dimcad. This has been my review. Thank you for watching. Bye.